Hi everyone, here in this lecture we are going to talk about what is the fertilization and how this process is going to take place in female genital tract. So what is fertilization? Fertilization means the fusion of two pronucleus, that is one from male and one from female, and this fusion ultimately forms a single cell, that is mononucleated diploid cell, that is called zygote. So before we start with this process, just see in the figure how these sperm cells travel along the genital tract and reaches up to the secondary oocyte. So here I am drawing the vagina. And then through this vaginal route, these sperm cells enter into the cervical canal and then to the body part or the uterine cavity, and after that these enter into the fallopian tube and here it is the ovary that actually releases the secondary oocyte, and the outline of the structure is here it is the uterus, and the vagina. So the fertilization is going to take place in ampullary part of the fallopian tubes, as it is the longest and the widest part out of the remaining parts of the fallopian tube. So the fertilization is always occurs in the ampullary part. If you remember, or you can see in my previous video of ovulation, that we have studied how these ovaries releases secondary oocyte from the mature graafian follicle, and that secondary oocyte travel along the tract and reaches in the ampullary part as it is widest. So here it is the secondary oocyte, and this secondary oocyte is covered by a single layer of glycoprotein zona pellucida, and this then covered by few layers of granulosa cells, and these granulosa cells called corona radiata over here. So the fusion of secondary oocyte with the sperm cell actually lead to the fertilization. So fertilization is usually happens around the day of ovulation, and we have studied that ovulation is going to be take place on the mid of the cycle, that is day 14. So the fertilizing lifespan of this secondary oocyte is ranges from 12 to 24 hours, and the fertilizing lifespan for the sperm cell is for about 48 to 72 hours. So the fertilization is taken place around the day of ovulation. And what is the ovulation? We have studied that it is the release of secondary oocyte from this ovary, from the mature graafian follicle, and then the secondary oocyte enters into the ampullary part. Now the process of fertilization begins with the process of copulation, and the copulation leads to release of semen, that is ejaculation of semen into the vagina. So this process begins with the copulation. It means the sexual intercourse between the male and female, and that process lead to the release of semen, ejaculation into the vagina. Before we see how these sperm cells travel along the tract and reaches the secondary oocyte, just see what is the semen. Semen, or the seminal fluid, it is the mixture of cells, that is sperm cell, with the various secretion from the accessory glands of the male reproductive system. So semen is the mixture of cell as well as the fluid, and the fluid which is released from the gland are, the glands are the seminal vesicles, and this seminal vesicles contribute about 60 to 70% of the fluid portion. And from these seminal vesicles, some substances are released, and these are the fructose and the prostaglandins. And some clotting proteins. So these substances are released from the seminal vesicles. So how these substances help these sperm cells to travel along this track? Firstly, the fructose. Fructose, it means the energy source. So energy is needed for these sperm cells to migrate along the whole of the track. As we have studied, that there is a spirally arranged mitochondria in the middle piece of the sperm, and that mitochondria needed the ATP in form of energy, which is required for the motility of sperm so that it can easily travel. So this movement is required by this energy source, and this energy source in form of fructose is given by this fluid. Now the another substance, that is the prostaglandin, very important role play here by these prostaglandin, is that as the sperm cells reaches in the uterine cavity, these prostaglandin help in the uterine contraction, and by these contraction, these sperm cells propel toward the fallopian tube. The another one is the clotting protein. This is also very helpful. As the ejaculation is taken place, if the clotting protein is absent in that condition, what will happen? The semen will be drained out easily. So to prevent from this draining, these clotting protein help the sperm cell to attach with the vaginal wall or to latch on from this wall so that they will be adhere here. So clotting protein from the seminal vesicle help to remain in the vagina. Is that clear? Okay. So we have studied that semen form from the fluid portion of the various glands. So one of the gland is seminal vesicle, and the another gland which contribute about 30% in the semen is the prostate. So prostate gland is the another important gland, as it releases the citric acid. This is also required for the energy for the sperms to move along the track, and the another is a fibrinolysin. This is very important substance, as these clotting proteins help the semen to coagulate over here. After few minutes, fibrinolysin help them to reliquefy so that it can easily travel along the track. Okay, so this helpful for reliquefying the semen and to propel the sperms to move along the track. So 70% contribution by the seminal vesicles and 30% by the prostate, and very few amount is contributed by the bulbourethral glands. And these all then forms the semen or the seminal fluid, the liquid portion, and remaining the 10%, most of are the fluid portion, and the remaining 10% is the sperm cells. Okay. So after the ejaculation, very important steps is going to take place in this fertilization, and that is the capacitation. So what it is? It's simply washing away the excess protein which is present over the head region of the sperm cells, and the another to make the sperm cells to become hypermobile. So by this capacitation, the excess protein is washed away, because fertilization is going to be take place around the ovulation, and at the time of ovulation, estrogen releases some amount of fluid from this uterine cavity as well as the cervical secretion, and these secretion washes away the excess protein which is present over the head region of the sperms. And by this capacitation, these sperm cells goes into the uterine cavity. They get the alkalinic secretion that favors them to become more motile. And finally, with the hypermotile activity and by this tubular secretion, by the ciliary movements and by the peristaltic movement of this tube, help these hypermotile sperm to reach nearby the secondary oocyte. So what a beauty of this is that the millions of sperms are ejaculated in the vagina and the thousands only capacitated till the uterine cavity, and very few hundreds, that is 200 to 500 cells only, sperm cells reaches nearby the secondary oocyte to make the secondary oocyte fertile. It is said that in each ejaculation there is about 2 to 5 ml semen which is deposited into vagina, and in that 5 ml semen there is 500, near about 500 million sperms which are lying in the vagina to become fertile. But as we have seen, only 200 to 500 sperm cells are there to reach the secondary oocyte. Okay. Now after capacitation, as the sperm cells reaches the secondary oocyte, we'll see here by the next figure what is happening here. Here it is the secondary oocyte, and this is the plasma membrane of secondary oocyte, that is ulema. And this ulema is covered by one glycoprotein layer, that is zona pellucida. And this zona pellucida is covered by again few granulosa cells surrounding them, and these are called corona radiata. And in between these corona radiata cells or the granulosa cells, there are the fluid within them. In between them is the hyaluronic acid. So what happened next? The 100 of capacitated sperms reaches near the secondary oocyte. Here it is the sperm cells. And these capacitated sperm cells, in that sperm cell, it is the head region, and this head region contains the nucleus with the haploid number of cell, and on top of that there is cap-like structure that is called acrosome, which contains some enzyme to digest this zona layer. Then these capacitated sperm cells are being attracted by the protein which is present on this zona pellucida layer, and the protein is called here is ZP3 or ZP3, that is zona pellucida 3 protein. So these are attracted by these proteins which are lying on the zona pellucida layer. And once it is attracted by these releases, this acrosomal cap releases few enzyme, that is hyaluronidase, that digest this corona radiata layer and finally attach by this protein. So here you can see this is a protein on zona pellucida layer. And by digesting this corona radiata, this finally attached by this protein, and what important step now is going to be take place is that the acrosomal reaction. The important step is the acrosomal reaction is going to take place. So what happened in this reaction? This protein is attract these capacitated sperm and make them attach with them, and as this attaches, what important step is going to take place here is that this plasma membrane of these sperm cells is fuses with this acrosomal membrane. So as these both fuses, what will happen next? it releases its enzyme over here. So acrosomal cap releases its enzyme, and as it releases, few substances are releases, that is hyaluronidase, few hydrolytic enzymes, proacrosin, acrosin. These all substances are releases, and these substances help to digest this zonal layer. Is that clear? So the step which is going to take place over here is occurring at many sites. Okay, so not only one, but many of the sperm are trying to get inside the secondary oocyte. So many of the sperm are attached with this zona pellucida third protein, that is ZP3 protein, to being get inside the secondary oocyte. But what happened here is that the sperm cell which digests the ZP3 layer, and the cell which first touches this ulema, the cell which touches the ulema or the plasma membrane of oocyte first is Winderase. And as this plasma membrane of sperm cell touches this plasma membrane of oocyte first, create the another reaction, and this is very important and called cortical reaction. And what happened in this cortical reaction? The first sperm cell which hit this oocyte, it make changes into the oocyte's cytoplasm, that is it activate the cortical granules. It activate the cortical granules to fuse with this ulema. Here it is the cortical granule that fuses with this ulema, and these cortical granules finally releases some hydrolytic enzyme from there, and these hydrolytic enzyme digest the zona pellucida at multiple levels, and also it creates a tight block or creates secondary oocyte to become more hard. It blocks the polyspermy. What it does? It blocks the polyspermy. So what is polyspermy? As I have told you before, that not a single cell trying to get inside the oocyte, whereas in there are the multiple sperm cell that attaches with this protein to get inside this cell. So by this cortical reaction and the cortical granules which releases hydrolytic enzyme and make this ulema to become hard, this stops the further sperms to become attached with this layer or to get inside this oocyte, because this oocyte only needed one genetic material from the one sperm cell. It doesn't require many of the genetic material to come inside the cell. Is that clear? So this is how the cortical reaction is going to take place, in that the cortical granules releases hydrolytic enzyme and block this polyspermy. Now as the polyspermy become blocked and this plasma membrane of the sperm cells, when it fuses with this ulema or the plasma membrane of oocyte, now it releases its genetic material into the cell's cytoplasm, that is haploid number of chromosome, and there it is called the male pronuclei. So once the genetic material of sperm cells enter into the cytoplasm, it is called male pronucleus. As male pronuclei get inside this oocyte cytoplasm, the important event is going to take place. What? The secondary oocyte was arrested in metaphase second. If you remember, it was arrested in metaphase second. So once it get inside the cell, now this secondary oocyte complete its meiotic second division and finally forms the two cells, one with the whole of the cytoplasm with the haploid number of chromosome forms the definitive ovum, and the another with the small or the scanty cytoplasm with the same haploid number of chromosome, and this is formed because to remove the extra number of chromosome which is formed by this division. So what happened, as the division completes, this definitive ovum with the haploid number of chromosome becomes the female pronuclei. So the event which is going to take place next is that is the fusion of this female pronuclei with this male pronuclei and forms the single cell with the diploid number of chromosome here is now called as zygote. So this is how by these all three steps the fertilization is going to take place. The capacitation, that is removing of excess protein over the head and becoming the more motile and travel along the whole of the tract to reach nearby the secondary oocyte. And the second step by the acrosomal reaction, and in this the plasma membrane of this sperm cell is fuses with the acrosomal membrane and to act upon this ZP3 protein and releases some hydrolytic enzyme so that this layer could be diffused easily. And the third one, as the diffusion takes place and the sperm cell touches the first sperm cell which touches this ulema, what the important reaction is going to take place next is that the cortical reaction. So the cortical granules from the cytoplasm fuse with this ulema and release this hydrolytic enzyme, so no more sperm cells can easily be attracted by this protein and can be attached by this protein, and no further sperm cells can be able to enter into the cell. So the cortical reaction is going to take place to block the polyspermy, and as the polyspermy become blocked, the genetic material get into the cytoplasm, becomes the male pronuclei, it completes its second meiotic division, forms the definitive ovum, and this female pronucleus and the male pronuclei fuses together and forms the single mononucleated cell with a diploid number of chromosome, that is called zygote, and it is indicative of that the woman is being pregnant.